แล้วที่ Digestive Endoscopy Center create FC Endoscopy Series for Endoscopy Education. This is FC GI Endoscopy Series. Emphasize on GI Luminal. I would like to express my gratitude to Thai Association for Gastrointestinal Endoscopy, Boston Scientific for support this program.And also, I would like to thank Dr. Thanyaporn Chandrasiri, our colleague who do beautiful medical illustration in this program. FC GI Endoscopy Series number 4 Acacia Endoscopic Treatment. Learning objective, diagnosis and classification, step approach, treatment modality and device, including technique of treatment.Achalasia is a primary sexual motility disorder characterized by impaired relaxation of lower sexual sphincter (LES) in response to swallowing, causing functional obstruction at esophagic junction. Mostly present with dysphagia. Diagnosis based on endoscopy, barium, esophagram, and one of the gold standard sexual manometry.And CAT scan in optional. This the picture to show on the left hand side. This the endoscopy. You can see dilated esophagus and tight esophagic junction without tumor mass. The barium esophagram to see the bird beak appellant and SRM. You can see tight 1, tight 2, tight 3. This the High pressure zone of lower esophageal sphincter. Functional evaluation of achalasia. Mostly we use Edgar score for symptom evaluation. We use the criteria of weight loss, dysphagia, lactosterol pain, and regurgitation. Score 0 is normal. Score 1, weight loss less than 5 kg.Occasional dysphagia, lactosterol pain, and regurgitation. Score 2, weight loss 5 to 10 kg, and daily symptom dysphagia, lactosterol pain, and regurgitation. If score 3, weight loss more than 10 kg, dysphagia, lactosterol pain, and regurgitation in each meal. The interpretation, the level 0, score 0 to 1,Level 1, 0, scores 2 to 3. This is good in terms of the remission. The level 2 score 4 to 6. And level 3 score more than 6. This is a poor response of the treatment. And also we can use time barium esophagram to measure the scale high pressure in terms of centimeter.After ingest 200 of the barium, we measure the height of the barium at the 0, 1, and 5 minutes. The interpretation is normal 100% M3 in 2 minutes. If less than 3 cm height at 5 minutes, good response. If more than 5 cm height, this is a pathologic molar retention. Normally, we use time barium.Before and after treatment to evaluation response of the treatment. High resolution sphere manometry, one of the gold standard to diagnose achalasia and also provide specific type of achalasia to select method of treatment. This can divide to type 1.Type 2 and type 3 achalasia. Type 1 hypotonic 100% failed pretensis IRP more than 15 mmHg. Type 2 pan pressurization and type 3 spastic contraction. If FIM is not available, you also can use barium swallowingTo predict type of achalasia. This is a new proposal prognostic gating system using dynamic barium solving FBF score by Italian group. They used 5 morpho dynamic findings as score criteria 0 to 12. But big size to point. Luminal dilation less than 4 cm to point. 4 to 6 cm 4 point and more than 6 cm 6 point. You can see it score more than 8. This type 1 achalasia. 6 to 8 type 2 achalasia. And less than 6 this type 3 achalasia. Sensitivity roughly more than 90%. There are several options for endoscopic treatment of achalasia: Botox injection, pneumatic balloon dilation, pleural endoscopic myotomy probe, and metallic stent placement. Start with Botox injection. 1 vial botulinum toxin type A containing 100 unit. BP load 100 unit diluted in 5 ml of normal saline, in 5 ml saline, and inject 1 ml containing 20 unit of botulinum toxin per injection. 4 quadrant injection into musculate propria 1 cm above thigh EG junction. Transparent cap is very helpful for endoscopic injection. US guided may be used in some cases. You can see the cap is really helpful. Keep the cap 1 cm above EG junction and inject needle. You can see the mucosa not swelling because the injection into the muscle, and inject 1 ml in 4 quadrant. The second method is the pneumatic balloon dilation. This is the device, new standard gastroscope, CO2 in subfetter, stiff ESP KY. This legitimate balloon by Boston Scientific, 30, 35, and 40 millimeter diameter balloon. We also use the saline bag fluoroscopy contrast study, and always when I use this technique, I prepare the device for culture perforation that might happen to the scope clip, over the scope clip, or even fully cover metal stent, and inform surgeon for standby in some extensive perforation. The technique do upper endoscopy to identify EG junction and place external needle tip marker at the EG junction under fluoroscopy. Insert guide wire deeply into the stomach. Remove endoscope and insert selected legitimate balloon across EG junction. You can select 3 cm in diameter for the first dilation, or 35 millimeter diameter in repeated or recurrent achalasia. And I also place plastic IV bag over the marker to see the waste. This you can see the 4 marker. These 2 marker at the middle, you keep the 2 marker of the balloon at the EG junction. If you slowly increase the pneumatic balloon until you lot of waste. This video to show the technique. upper endoscopy, place the wire deeply into the stomach, and then identification of the EG junction, and may place electro marker, remove endoscope. You can see really dilated and insert late effect. This is the 30 millimeter in diameter. You can see this, the two marker in the center, and then slowly inflate and inside the balloon. You can see really slowly inflate. You can see the waist, and then you adjust the marker at the waist. When I put the plastic back, I can see the waist more clearly. You can see. Then now we adjust the marker at the waist at the EG junction, and we increase the pressure until the loss of weight and keep 1 minute, and then remove the balloon, laryngoscopy to check the bleeding and perforation, and inject contrast to make sure no any perforation. This pneumatic balloon dilation protocol, policy recommend use guided pneumatic balloon dilation. ACG recommend to initial dilation with the 30 mm balloon diameter and follow up symptom and objective assessment in 4 to 6 weeks, and consider the dilation in neck side of balloon in unresponse from 30 to 35. ESG guideline also recommend initial dilation with the 30 mm balloon diameter and followed by 35 in neck 2 to 4 weeks, and followed by 40 millimeter balloon diameter in next 2 to 4 weeks when insufficient relief of the symptom. Mostly we start with the 30 balloon size and then step up bigger if a symptom is symptomatic. One of the major adverse events, perforation, roughly 2 to 3%, repeated dilation, and large balloon diameter is a risk factor. You can manage with endoscopic keeping and some case fully cover methods needed, or even surgery in uncontrolled perforation. In this particular case, perforation we can control with chemoclip. Post-procedure care, observe symptom fasting for 6 hours, awareness of the perforation, detect chest pain, abdominal pain or subcutaneous emphysema or fever, and consider anti-emetic drug. After fasting 4 to 6 hours, you can start with liquid to semi-solid. If no any symptom, the patient can leave from the hospital and inform the patient. May come back if you encounter abnormal symptom and reevaluation at 4 to 6 weeks with ECAS score. Per overall endoscopic myotomy problem, this one of the popular treatment of achalasia. You need to prepare upper endoscope, CO2 in subfilter, water allocation, distal transparent cap, especially salinal tie, electrocycle unit, this setting proposed by person weight. And this all equipment you need to prepare, especially the TT9, Quake Casper, diluted blue dye with normal saline, and distal attachment hood, clip, injection needle. The concept and step technique to perform peroral endoscopic myotomy. We keep the patient in supine under general anesthesia with internal CO2 monitoring capnography However, some center use lateral position. The number one, make sure already clean is still lumen without food material and give prophylactic antibiotic. Number two, inject water into the lumen to identify the posterior site by water pooling. Identify each junction by measure the length from the bile box to each junction dealing with withdrawal from the stomach. And the concept of myotomy in type 1 and type 2, cut isocyte 5 cm and 2 cm above proximal contraction from SIM in type 3 achalasia. For the isthmal incision 2 cm long above the proximal myotomy site, and you can measure the length of myotomy and incision and select posterior approach, use 5 o'clock direction. And if you select anterior approach, use 2 o'clock direction. Step, start with inject 10 ml of diluted blue dye namoxaline into the submucosal space. Use TT9 inside. Paste the yellow pad. Cut 2 cm mucosal deeply into the submucosal space. Insert tip of scope with transparent cap into the submucosal space. Dissect submucosal space, tunneling widely with move paddle coax spray until least lower isthmal sphincter that you can identify by longitudinal muscle, palisade vessel, and the great vessel, especially in gastric side, or you come back into the gastric lumen, you can see the blue dye containing. And also you can observe the bone vessel and try to keep the tension right to the double vessel to minimize interrupt of the reflux. And let's say down to 2 cm in the gastric side, and you can identify with the double scope technique and start myotomy as Pan already mentioned, mostly from proximal to distal, or some doctors start from distal to proximal, and you can cut circular or complete circular and longitudinal. Check bleeding and close mucosal incision with clip. Algorithm approach accuracy in anticipation proposed by Nabi and colleague from AIG. In suspected ischemic motility disorder by endoscopy or barium soaring to perform high resolution manometry to get diagnosis of achalasia and assess the patient's status if unfit for surgery, recommend to use Botox. Toxin injection, mouth pharmacotherapy or metal stent placement in selected patient. If the patient fit for surgery, depend on the type of achalasia, type 1 and type 2, you can select pneumatic balloon dilation, pleural endoscopic myotomy or standard Heller myotomy with fundoplication. In type 3 achalasia, prefer pleural endoscopic myotomy over Heller myotomy, plus fundoplication in terms of more extent cut in ischiocyte. In the patient prior failed treatment, depend on the type of the initial treatment, and also you need to study confirm failure of the treatment by SIM. Time isogram and endoscopy. Once again, the patient unfit for surgery, select Botox or metal stent placement. If fit for surgery, if initial treatment use pneumatic balloon dilation, move to pleural endoscopic myotomy or surgery with Heller myotomy part fundoplication. If previous Heller myotomy, the second choice may be select balloon dilation or POEM or even Heller myotomy, but in this situation it's more difficult because you need approach posterior and fail the first POEM, you can re-POEM or pneumatic balloon dilation or Heller myotomy depend on experience of the surgeon. Summary in treatment modality, Botox toxin injection, first-line treatment in the patient who unfit for surgery. Pneumatic balloon dilation is good for the patient, can be operated. Guided technique is safe and effective. Usually start in 30 mm balloon diameter. It's good candidate in type 1 and type 2 achalasia. For Heller myotomy plus fundoplication provide good long-term outcome in type 1 and type 2. Pleural endoscopic myotomy POEM safe and effective in all type of achalasia and prefer over the other method in type 3 achalasia. Some high incidence of reflux disease compared with the Heller. In summary, diagnosis of achalasia require history, endoscopy, barium, especially time barium isogram, high resolution manometry, and selected case to perform CT scan of chest. High resolution manometry is crucial to select proper endoscopic treatment. Endoscopic myotomy valuation is stratified for type 1 and type 2, but preferable in type 3 with POEM. Keep proton injection in unfit for endoscopic or surgical treatment. And clinical score, time barium swelling is recommended to subjective and objective post procedure evaluation. Hopefully you can get some small thing to improve your practice. Thank you very much for visiting our channel. See you in FC Endoscopy Series.